Now, I'd like to say that we're well on our way and we're making great progress. And the Institute of Medicine has done a phenomenal job of advocating in their various reports for this new vision. It's what I call Charles Schwab meets Nordstrom's meets the Mayo Clinic. In other words, the kind of e-enablement of a Charles Schwab with the customer patient centricity of a Nordstrom's and the team-based, evidence-based, organized, integrated, salaried care of a Mayo Clinic. I'd like to say that's what's happening everywhere, but that's not what I see. And the main what I see in American healthcare is what I call pimp my ride healthcare. Now, if you do not have teenagers, you will have no clue what I'm talking about. So let me just take a moment. Now, my kids are both in college. Actually, they're both graduating in a month, which is brilliant. Get the biggest wage increase of my life. But anyway. So when they were in high school, I watched a lot of MTV. Otherwise, I had nothing to talk to them about, basically. And I got hooked on the show. And it is the single best show on television. I mean, if you're not watching Pimp My Ride, you are missing a life-altering experience. For those of you who haven't seen it, it's on MTV. How it works is this charming rapper exhibit goes to some unsuspecting youth who is usually, you know, going to community college and working at Starbucks and driving this beaten-up old camper hybrid truck or a Pinto, actually, is a very popular vehicle. And he takes the vehicle from them, and they go to this West Coast custom auto body shop in L.A., and they transform the vehicle, and they take out the seats and put in unbelievable upholstery, and they put in fantastic sound systems and paint jobs. I mean, I watched an episode not long ago, and there was a 1979 Toyota Corolla, green, ugly, transformed it, great paint job, and in the trunk of the car, they put a PowerBook G4. And he turned to the girl, you know, at the end of the show, and he said, "We put a PowerBook G4 in the trunk of the car, Apple PowerBook, with 50,000 songs on iTunes." And she was just delirious. And he said, "If that's not enough, we put 6 terabytes of storage in the trunk of the car, so you can have 2 million songs." Have you any idea how long it would take you to listen to 2 million songs? I did the math. 11 years, 3 months, sitting in the car, listening to goddamn rap music, okay? They never do anything to the engine. So, that troubled me, okay? So I'm watching this one night, and I said, you know what? This is a perfect metaphor for American healthcare. Cool. What do? We take a really bad chassis, okay? I mean, with all due respect, medicine is a 100-year-old organizational form. And then we pile on all this stuff, this unbelievable technology on a frame that's tired, old, and ineffective. We got huge expense on buildings, machines, drugs, devices, and people at West Coast Custom Healthcare. And the people who own the rights are deliriously happy because they didn't pay for it in a world of catastrophic coverage. Once you're, you know, have a ride through an MRI at Stanford, you're over your deductible. You could care less how much this stuff costs. And it all looks great, has a fantastic sound system and nice seats, but it will break down if you try and drive it anywhere. And that's exactly what we have across the country. We have Pimp My Ride healthcare. And, you know, how we got there was quite simple. It's through a pay-for procedure orientation in our payment system. I mean, I stole this from Elliot Fisher. I mean, this is the classic Pimp My Ride example. The top line here is coronary bypass surgery rates in the Medicare population in Redding, California. And the green line is the California average. Now, those of you who have cardiovascular or cardiology training will be amazed to know, you'll be sort of saying, well, what cardiovascular miracle took place in Redding, California? Well, the answer was the FBI arrived, okay? This was, you may recall, some years ago, there were two overly enthusiastic coronary bypass surgeons in Redding who were doing, at a for-profit hospital, who were doing CABGs not only on every Medicare recipient, but on most of the large farm animals, apparently. So they got taken out in a fraud and abuse scandal, and lo and behold, the average pertained, you know, once they were gone. Now, the reason I say it will break down when you try and drive it anywhere is we have coming at us over the next decade and the next two decades, a triple tsunami of chronic care needs that will overwhelm our current health system. And it is obesity and the related heart disease and diabetes. It is cancer as a chronic condition. We're not going to cure cancer, but we're going to keep people alive with cancer as a chronic condition for much, much longer. And it's depression, which is pandemic. Now, we're not unique in this. Every country is struggling with an obesity epidemic. We're just further ahead than everybody because we have the junk food from everywhere else, basically. Mexico is number two. It's a rice and refried beans culture. Then come the fish and chip and shortbread countries. That's where I'm from. It's like the UK, Australia, New Zealand, Canada. Then come the sausage countries. Ireland, Germany, Spain, Iceland, Belgium, Poland. Then the smoked fish countries, Sweden, Holland, Denmark. Then there's a little piece of bony fish on a bed of arugula for 35 euros. That's France. And then the sushi countries are at the bottom. Now, the reason this stuff's important is that this is going to overwhelm us. I mean, we just can't keep doing pimp-marade healthcare on those kinds of patients.